We're sitting here at PetSmart. We just did a little shopping for Buck and got him some Nature's Miracle and a collar and some pill pockets for all the pills he'll be taking over the next few weeks. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit today about the investigation, because there's a lot of inquiries about what's going on with that. First, keep in mind that today is Saturday, January 12th, I think. And please keep in mind that it's only been 7 days since this happened. And because of all the initial attention I had to give to Buck, I didn't get the evidence over to the investigators for 3 to 4 days. So they've only really had the case for a few days. I can assure you, I can promise you and assure you that they are doing everything they can to find the person that did this to Buck. But what is happening right now, y'all love Buck so much that people are taking it upon themselves, and they've somehow found the investigator, and they're calling his office, and they're bombarding him with calls right now. And this is distracting him from what he needs to do and preventing him from moving forward, which is what you're wanting him to do. So I'm asking you to please, you know, be patient, let them do their work. I can assure you, with all of Buck's international fans, he's got over 40,000 fans right now, that they are doing everything they can to solve this case. And it's going to get the proper attention. If they do a sloppy investigation, they're not going to get a conviction. So it's very important we let them do their job. And I just please ask you, don't be calling. And then also, I am not able to see all your messages. I really apologize, but I'm getting a lot of messages. I do try to get on every day. I spent a few hours answering private messages and all that, but I can't get to them all. And I know those questions are out there in the investigation. So the people that are seeing this video, you have the information now. When people are asking about the investigation, help me out and answer them and tell them, you know, be patient, let's wait. They're pursuing it. It's going to take a little bit of time, but I promise you they're doing everything they can. And I feel really confident we're going to get the person. So thank you for your help, and thank you for your love and support for Buck. He loves you, and I love you too.
And Buck is taking quite a bit of your time right now. Buck's been taking quite a bit of your time. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, you know, the first few days it was just all about his medical needs, and then me reaching out trying to figure out how am I going to pay for this, because when I loaded him into my car, I didn't know how I was going to pay for it. This was like an act of faith. And then, you know, within a day and a half to 2 days, my whole life changed. And then it was like, well, how am I going to handle this situation? All that thought, you know, arranging for the doctor visits. I was really trying at first to, you know, answer all your messages and be a part of everything that's happening. I have a lot of other rescue animals at my house that require my attention. Just I have a life too, and I have some jobs I do, and it's just a lot right now. I haven't been getting a lot of sleep. I'm up till 5-6 in the morning on the internet trying to answer people. I'm getting like 2 to 3 hours sleep a night. If in a perfect world I would answer every single one of your messages, they're all full of love. I feel it, I recognize it, I appreciate it, I know you support me, and I'm blessed. I am being blessed to be a blessing. And I promise you, wonderful things are going to happen from Buck's tragedy. We're going to turn this horrible thing into something really good and wonderful for other animals like Buck that are victims of cruelty and abuse. And then we're also going to reach out to the children in the community I live, and we're going to try to educate them and, you know, make a future generation of humans that are more aware of this subject, because we all know there's a direct link between animal abuse and then later moving on to abusing humans and other crimes. So it's important to just teach these people and educate them. And to me, the most important thing is also what I said in my first video. Nothing's going to love you like a dog. Even your mama isn't going, because your mama's going to get mad at you at some point, but your dog isn't. There's this joke many of you may have heard. If you put your husband and your dog in a trunk and you open it up, who's going to be happy to see you? It's going to be your dog, not your husband. So, you know, dogs are wonderful creatures. They love unconditionally. I love cats and other animals too. And so we need to reach these people, because the people that do these crimes are, in my opinion, they're lacking seriously something in their heart. They're lacking love in their life. Something went wrong. And a dog, in my opinion, could cure that if somehow we could connect the love of a dog to these people that are committing these crimes. I don't know how you do that. We're going to try to do that with Buck, and we're going to try to make a big difference. And I know we are going to. So thank you for your support.